Yo, 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 what's up everybody? You back here at Channel None and All Now on YouTube, and I am your host, the Dome of the Rock. So, we released some videos this weekend that were obviously very cerebral and potentially controversial and spiritually inclined, very mystical in nature and very forceful and impactful for some. That are challenging some of the normalcies that the world would like to maintain strictly in place. People are going to be reacting to that, obviously. So let's delineate that reaction, shall we? Now, you know, the obvious first reaction is, hey, that guy's crazy. You know, and if that's what you're thinking, hey, keep thinking. Don't hurt yourself, all right? So, for the rest of us moving forward, there are obvious psychological, sociological, and potential anthropological impacts of videos like this being shared on the internet. They begin at a personal level for me as a person, since I am the person who is putting these videos out. And I am the one who is putting myself in this position. I'm probably not exactly a fit scientist to analyze this. It's kind of like I'm observing myself. But one of my spirit names is He Who Sees His Own Face. So, you know, maybe I'm good at watching myself. But at any rate, I am watching myself through this whole thing. I have been watching myself through this whole thing. It started in 1999 and it instantly cracked open this entire experience that has really gone everywhere it goes, and that feels very, very, very comfortable in me, and that's supported by a stream of synchronistic events in the world around me. That has a psychological impact on me, and makes me feel quite strongly that what I need to do is be sharing this thing with the world, because it wants to be shared. The world seems to want it to be shared. And regardless of how the world will react once it actually is shared, because that changes everything, they want it until it's there. As soon as it's there, believe me, most people don't want it. But the impact of this, you know, happening, what's it going to do? Initially, what's it going to do to me? I've pretty much turned this thing over in my mind psychologically enough to have taken this in all different directions. I'm very, very, very comfortable. It doesn't really change who I am. I'm not a static thinker. I think in, you know, a dynamic web of infinite variables, and you know, it's just everything's, you're just focusing on stuff, you know. So wherever we're focusing on, that's what we're talking about and trying to describe. And so, you know, it's constantly moving around, though, over this whole thing. It's not, you don't ever try to talk about the whole thing all at once, because that would just be, you know, that's pretty much it. But, okay, so they have a word for it, by the way. At any rate, so if we're just examining that, you know, it takes you into all kinds of things. What has it done to me? What has it done to my mind? What has it done to my way of thinking? There are all kinds of questions that you should be asking yourselves if you're scientists examining this thing, like especially psychologically. I would assume that there are psychologists out there who examine people who have this phenomena. I know that this phenomena is really, really, really quite widespread. There's another person within my immediate, you know, social in-group, which is like a dozen people, maybe, you know, maybe like two dozen people, but there's already one more, you know, there's possibly more than one more. So like, there's probably lots of people it happens to. I'm finding people who it's happened to all the time. There's stories and all kinds of things. It's not just the ones you know. A lot of people are holding it in. What are the effects of all of a sudden letting it out? Could this be used as some kind of therapy for this? I don't know. You figure that out. That's not where my journey is taking me. But I'm going to share it with you nevertheless right here, right now. Now, immediate impacts outside of myself. My family is obviously of critical concern. I have a woman and a child, and although the woman knows all about this thing, encourages it, supports it, and is fully aware that I'm doing it and that this was coming, it still makes her uncomfortable. The very first night that this happened, she had very good reason to wonder, and you know, I was wondering myself, were the police just going to come and break down the door and kill everybody? This is America. That shit happens to people here all the time, and they just cover it up and move on. So, like, what was this going to attract? All our friends going to suddenly leave us? Is her family going to find out and just put even more pressure on her to leave me? You know what I'm saying? Like, how am I ever going to break this to my kid? What's our relationship going to look like out of all of this at some point, someday? You know, am I ever going to have another friend again? Am I ever going to be able to get another job again? All of these things are critical concern, you know what I'm saying? Because no one, no matter who they are, especially the people probably I would think and have experienced who yakety-yak the most about this thing you call jizzy, even them, like, if they're proposed with this thing, like, at first they're like kind of cautious and shit, but as soon as they get any chance to like bite into it, what I sense from people is hatred and fear, you know what I'm saying? And that's pretty much, the world's dangerous, y'all have gone crazy for the most part, and you need somebody to show you the way, but doing so is a Socratic method that is likely to get one killed. So is this going to kill me? Is it possibly transitionable? Can I flip it and kick it and hit it? Oh, it landed and move on and keep, oh, boom, boom, boom. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? We're going to find out. That's a question. Can I get, you know, sponsorship? Is anybody going to publicize me? Is any, you know, media mogul icon person that wants to turn me into a personality sensation want to see this? And like, am I going to get rich? Am I going to get famous? Am I going to, you know, build this YouTube army out of my own thing and like someday like take over the world, become like the king of the zombies or like the king of the pirates or like, you know, like set the world free? Be like, yeah, you know, who knows? You know, we're going to find out. Am I going to just be mercilessly slaughtered and then unleashed into the fucking ambient universe, and then you guys are really going to see what I'm made of after that? Oh boy, let me tell you something, because everything don't mean a thing when you with me, baby. All right, so, you know, that's the way it is. I'm King Bullshit, you know? That's what my friends know me as. That's what they call me, King Bullshit. And they say to me, religion is bullshit. So if I'm King Bullshit and religion is bullshit, then I must be the king of religion. If I'm the king of religion, then religion's not bullshit. Ooh, what you got to say now? You know what I'm saying? That's where I'm at with people. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, what are people going to do? What are they going to think? I've had people tell me already this is my ego. I was preserving my ego before letting this information out. That's the way I look at it. Letting this information out is the potential for it to do something horribly harmful to me and my family is much greater than for it to do anything good for me. But the potential is there either way. That's what we're saying. Where's the distribution? How does the continuum fall? Those are questions that might be able to be plotted and graphed by an analyst somewhere down the line. At any rate, you know, the cat's out of the bag, and you know, this offer's on the table, and I have broke it out and put it out there, and you know, I'm gonna keep working with it, and I'm gonna keep working alongside with it mostly in the background. I pretty much only brought the, you know, personality up to the forefront for Easter week alone, and now that it's past Easter week, I will probably for the most part put it back in the bag and move on like everything is cool. But I will obviously not always do that, and when the thunder comes cracking and calling, you all will know where it comes from and what has inspired it. And hey, I'm a modern mystic. This is my experience, and you're witnessing it here on YouTube channel None and All Now. Yeah, baby. See you tomorrow.